वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ शेख विद्या मंदिर इंग्लिश हाई स्कूल एंड जूनियर कॉलेज. होप यू ऑल आर फाइन. स्टूडेंट्स, यू ऑल मस्ट बी फेमिलियर विद दीज टू एंशंट वेल नोन इंडियन एपिक्स, दैट इज़ द रामायण एंड द महाभारत, विच इज़ मेड फेमिलियर टू यू सिंस योर चाइल्डहुड, इज़न्ट इट? सिंस चाइल्डहुड यू हैव दीज नॉलेज अबाउट द रामायण, द स्टोरीज ऑफ रामायण, द plays what you are watching from your childhood, the Mahabharata, what you used to watch on the television, and so on. So you have a good knowledge of all these Indian epics. Likewise, if you talk about Western epics, in the European literature, we get to know about the Iliad and the Odyssey by Homer. The writer of these epics was Homer. The children in these countries are very familiar with these brave warriors. They know a lot about them. Like you know a lot about your Indian epics, they know a lot about their Western literature or their Western epics. In our today's topic, we shall see about these ancient Greek warriors and know some history about them. We all know our Indian history, but let's know about a little bit of European culture or European history, which we will see in our today's lesson. It is the fall of Troy. It's in two parts, so we'll be first looking into the first part of the lesson. So let's get started, student. Here is a short summary of the entire story. Let's see. The Trojans kept the city safe by building strong walls and having great soldiers to defend it. It so happened that all the kings and heroes of Greece declared war against Trojans because Paris had convinced Helen, the wife of Greek King Menelaus, to elope with him. Elope is to run away with him. In the fight, the great heroes on both sides were killed. Hector was killed by Achilles, and Achilles died of a poisoned arrow which struck in his heel. And the Paris, the king himself, the prince of Troy himself was killed in the end. This is what we are going to see in the first part. So before we begin the story, let's take a quick look on the main characters of the story. Now in the main characters in the story, we get to see Menelaus and the Greek. Towards the Greek whom we have, the war was between Greek and the Trojans from Troy. So in the Greeks we had Menelaus, who was a Greek king. His wife is Helen. Achilles is a great warrior, and Odysseus is also a great warrior of those ancient literature. Towards the Trojans we had Paris, he's a prince of Troy, and Hector, he's a brave warrior and the eldest son of King Priam of Troy. So here we get to know a few characters which we'll be talking or seeing in this lesson. So here we begin with the Trojan War. Here are some highlights from the lesson which will help us to know the lesson much better. Let's get started. Epics are long poems that tell us about great national hero or a great national war. These epics are nothing but these are poems or a type of story or a type of narration where you come to know a lot about what the history was playing a role. So here are certain heroes or a national war being discussed. So this is what is being asked in this lesson. We have the famous Sanskrit Indian epics, which we know in India is the Ramayana and the Mahabharata. Likewise, Western epics are Iliad and Odyssey. These were the epics of European literature written in ancient Greek, in the old ancient time of their history in the Greek. Children all over India know the names of stories of Ram and Sita, Yudhishthira, Arjuna and Draupadi. So has the children in Western countries know the names of Hector and Odysseus and Achilles and Helen of Troy. These were the certain names where these Western literature knew a lot about it. Moving ahead, Helen, the most beautiful woman in the world, because of whom the Greek and Trojans fought for 10 long years. So the war which started between the Greek and Trojans went for 10 long years. It was only and only because of Helen, who was wife of King Menelaus. And the beautiful woman in the world she is to be known in that ancient time. The author of these early epics is unknown. The writer who has written these books are still unknown to us. But it is believed that the Iliad and the Odysseys were composed and recited by a blind poet named Homer. Now Homer was a poet who knew about all these things. He used to to bring out your feelings and expressions and write out something or sing out something, recite it. So he used to sing out and read out the Iliad and the Odysseys in those years. And that's how it is known that he has been a writer of that. still though we don't know the authors who have written them properly. Homer, who lived in the 900 BCE. Now BCE is before Common Era. So many, many years back this was written, and so it is not clarified as to who has written them properly. He wandered is searching, from one Greek city or village to another, singing his poems to all who would receive him in their homes and give him hospitality. He used to go singing, since he was a blind man, he used to go from house to house singing for people. The people who treated him, who wished to welcome him in their house, gave him good hospitality, is giving him service, providing him service, helping him because of his blindness, he used to always sing for them, and they used to treat him very well. This wandering singer has been honored through ages, not only in Greece, but in all Europe. Now this man being a good singer, though he was blind, he was being honored and respected from ages and in the entire Europe. And he's also known as the father of European poetry. The Iliad is the story of Ilium or Troy, Iliad. The Iliad part story is the story of the Troy. Now what is this Troy, and how does this Troy look, or what is the proper knowledge about this? Let's get from this part. It is a rich trading city in Asia Minor near the narrow sea that leads from the Aegean to the Black Sea. Now where does it properly situate? Now this Troy is properly situating towards Asian Turkey. That's the Anatolian plateau in the West Asia. This Asia Minor, there this Troy place was situated, that leads the Aegean to the Black Sea. It was well known for both commerce and agriculture. Now commerce is what? Buying and selling of goods and services, or transporting is commerce and agriculture. This place, Troy, was very famous for that. It was well known for both commerce and agriculture. In front of the city was the sea over which they sailed the ships of Troy carrying goods and grains. Now in front of the city, what they used to do, there was a sea, and over which they used to sail. Sailing is to be done, that is buying and selling, transporting is to be done, that is carrying of goods and grains. Goods are the commerce, and grains is because of the agriculture. The city was surrounded by Mount Ida, and the valley was well watered and fertile. It was having a beautiful mountain area which named Mount Ida, and the valleys were well watered and fertile. It was a clean and fertile land, a proper land for farming, with sheep and cattle feeding on the grass and meadows. Meadows are nothing but the area or the land which is covered with grass is called as meadows. So such a wonderful description you have got of this Troy, city Troy. City Troy, what did it have? It had huge mountains, and it was surrounded by valleys and sea too. Around the city, the Trojans had built a strong wall so that no enemy should attack them from the sea. Now this city was well prepared for the attackers to attack. So they had huge walls, huge thick walls, broad walls to protect them from the sea, from any attack from the enemy, and also the attack which comes from the sea, because it was very close to the sea. The wall was so broad that people could stand and sit and even walk on it. It was very broad and a very thick wall where people could even walk and sit. In times of war, the gates would be closed. They were huge gates, this Troy city. So they used to be closed, and the city was like a strong fortress, quite safe from all attacks. It was a quite strong fortress. Now what's a fortress? It's a large building that is used in a military protection. Large walls you see for military protection we have, these are called as fortresses. Quite safe from all attacks, protected by the walls surrounding it as well as by the hills behind. There were also hills on the other side, so they were all protected from all the side. Troy was a city strongly protected by its walls and defended by its brave soldiers. Even they had a good amount of brave soldiers who knew good fighting in those times. The kings and heroes of Greece had declared a war against the Trojans. Now the kings of Greece had, and the heroes, great heroes of Greece, had decided to take a war against these Trojans. As I told you, there was a war between the Greeks and the Trojans. Now let's see, why was this fight? The gates of Troy looked something like this. You can see how the beautiful scenario you have. The walls were so huge and so thick. Even you could stand on the gap, which is you can present the huge walls. And that's how this was a big open area where they could have good amount of fight. And the land, you can see how neat and clean it is. So fertile the land was also. So we move ahead. Paris, the prince of Troy, had convinced Helen wife of a Greek king Menelaus to run away and marry him. Now, why did the fight take exactly place? Because the prince of Troy, the prince from the Troy city, had wanted Helen, that is the queen, the Greek king Menelaus' wife. He wanted to marry her and wanted to take her away from Greek. He had brought Helen to Troy, so he wanted to do that and he did it. He brought Helen to Troy. The Greeks wanted to take revenge on Troy for doing wrong to their king Menelaus. Now the Greeks became very angry. It was a defending way. The Trojans somehow took away Helen from Greece. And now the Greeks were very anxious and very angry they became, because they wanted to fight back against to these people of Troy, because they took away their own king Menelaus' wife. Now the Greeks sailed to Troy and laid a trap to attack the city. So the Greeks were very angry, and so they decided to lay a trap or to lay a siege where they can attack the entire city. Now the fight started. The fight continued for at least 10 long years. The fighting went on daily, but the siege did not end. Siege means what exactly is forcing an armed force to surrender. Siege means you are not wanting to surrender, or you make someone surrender. I've captured the entire place and now I'm on that place only capturing you. So it's you, if you want to give up, it's called as to siege. The fighting went on daily, but the siege did not end. They did not give up the fight. On one hand, the Greeks could not take the city. On the other hand, the Trojans could not force them to sail away. Now, the problem was that on the one hand, the Greeks did not want to give up, could not take the city. They did not want to give up and they could not take the city because the city was very well protected. And on the other hand, the Trojans could not force them to sail away, because they had come to fight and now you can't force them to sail away. You cannot, because whose mistake it was? It was the Trojans who made a fault of getting the wife of King Menelaus to Troy. So it was their fault, so they could not ask for sailing them away. Every day the Trojans came out of their gates and the Greeks came out of their tents and ships, and the fighting went on. Every day the Trojans came out of the gates, Trojans came out to fight from the gates, and the Greeks came out of their tents. They had made tents to stay inside, and this went on. These Greeks and Trojans kept on fighting, and even the fighting ships which were being active when the fight was on. Sometimes there were great battles between the two armies. Sometimes there were single fights between the two great heroes. Sometimes there were great battles between the two armies. Depends on how the fight is to start. And sometimes only the two heroes used to fight. And that is in the beginning I told you. The two great heroes, that is Hector and Achilles. These two individuals used to fight. Sometimes the Trojans had a better of it. Means sometimes the Trojans won the war. And sometimes the Greeks won. Great heroes on both the sides were killed in the war even after leading the defense for 9 years. In the ninth year, the war which continued for 9 years long, in the end of the ninth year, the great heroes from both the sides were killed. Now the two heroes are Achilles and Hector. These two were killed. Now let's see how they were killed. The brave Hector was at last killed by Achilles, whom none could resist. Nobody could stop him or take control of him. That strong was Hector. And in the end, Achilles himself was killed by a poisoned arrow that entered his heel, the only part of the body where he could be wounded. The entire body, they wear an armor to protect themselves from any kind of weapon. And that was very difficult to attack Achilles, to kill Achilles. But the only place where he could be shotted is the arrow, poisoned arrow, was on his heel, that is the part of the leg. And the part of the leg, the exact arrow was being left, a poison arrow was left, and that's how the poison attacked him and he died. Still later, Paris himself was killed by a poisoned arrow. Now still later the fight continued, and it came to be known that Paris himself died in the end. The Trojans were tired of being shut up because they were inside their own city. In their city, and the Greeks were longing to see their homes again. The Greeks had left their place for Greece, and all the way they were near the Troy city. But still the fighting went on and it did not have an end. So that's how the story goes, student. Now here are certain meanings which are relevant from your text point of view. Please refer to the text and understand these meanings so that you can have a better understanding of the story. So students, here we have done with the first part of the lesson, that is the first part of the story of the fall of Troy. The remaining part of the lesson we shall see in our next video. Thank you.